Dang, I feel like it would have been more exciting if I did a show you how to go from this to this. But I didn't have the foresight to start with that when my hair was still in rollers. So here's how my hair looks, guys. I myself haven't even looked at the back yet. I hope it's not terrible. Hey guys, maybe this will end up on my YouTube channel. Maybe it won't. I don't know. I just had a very failed attempt at doing a makeup video, which is why I look like this. But I figured I would do a hair one still. Just try and see if I could figure this out. I hope I tested the camera again, see if it's at the right height. I have no clue. We are gonna see if this works. If not, I just won't do YouTube. And that's fine. Not everyone has to do everything. I roller set my hair probably once a week and maintain it from there. When I roller set it, I give it a nice clean wash, and then I use a Kenra product that I'll do a whole video about how I set my hair. But this one's pretty much about the brush out and styling. I set it in foam rollers if I'm gonna sleep in it. I actually had it out of, I had it in the rollers for a couple days because I had nothing to do yesterday. So I was like, well, why waste a good hair day? I'm gonna save it. So I decided I was saving it today, to today, and I wanted to make a YouTube video. So what I'm gonna do to start is take out every roller and brush it individually with my wet brush. So I brush out each one individually, and then I brush it all together. And I'll go through my entire head and do that. Obviously, I'm not gonna do much of that. I'm gonna speed this up in some way. So once I have all the rollers out, these are my bangs ones. I kind of always save these for last because I style my bangs separately from the rest. So now it's kind of just a game, for me, a game of like brushing and manipulating. This isn't a super informative video as you've seen. I didn't tell you what Kenra product I used to set my hair. I didn't show you how I set my hair. And all I'm doing is running a brush through it. I've run into this problem when I was teaching hair class too. I'm like, you know, you just like brush your hair. And people don't like that as a response to like, oh, how do you style your hair? Just brush it doesn't cut it. I have a horseshoe haircut. So what that means is it's shorter in the front and gets the longest at the center back, like a horseshoe shape. So my hair is kind of meant for styles like this. I like to go volume the first day because after day one, the curl kind of settles and I can re-manipulate it to be like a long page boy or just pretty waves. But day one, I can live the curl's life to its fullest before it fades at all. To get a nice wave on the top layer, especially, I'll run my comb around. And that's kind of that page boy wave that that page boy curl under that I was working on automatically just jumped into place when I ran this comb through it. I'm gonna say that rarely happens to me that I have something work out like that. So, don't expect that all the time to work, but it did. So let's pretend I'm a master hair artist. I'm gonna kind of keep running through it.
And that kind of, that page boy way that I, or that page boy curling that I was working on automatically just jumped into place when I ran the comb through it. I'm gonna say that rarely happens to me that I have something worked out like that, so, don't expect that all the time to work, but it did, so.
Well, let's pretend I'm a master hair artist. I'm gonna kind of keep running through it with the comb to get a smooth wave pattern together. Now, the mirror I have right now is at a weird angle, so I can't actually see 100% what my hair is doing. I'm gonna spritz my hair a little bit and get a little bit of hold in the places that I like right here. It's really, really good. This side, not as good, but I'm gonna work with it. But see, it's getting there. It's a lot of playing with your tools to get exactly what you want with your hair. It's, like I said, I'm not great at educating. I say super non-informative things a lot when I'm trying to teach someone how to do something. Like, you know, just do it. And I apologize. But, okay, so I've got some basic shape in there. I'm gonna do my bangs now, because these rollers look ridiculous because they're falling out of my head. When I do my bangs, I often style them as a whole. Instead of doing each individual roller, I'll comb and brush them out together immediately.
So they start marrying and blending. Sometimes like that, like, I stopped at it for a couple nights, so the rollers got loose and moved, so they might not want to marry very well and have the same curl pattern. Or they might. You never know how it's going to happen. I've done the same set every day for, 6 months at least, and, you know, it comes out different all the time.
I just put a little bit of a tease into it because I like some height. This audio might be fully skipped through. I'm not sure yet. I don't know how I'm doing. This YouTube thing, it's new. Not obviously to the masses, just to me. See, now I'm getting, I can see like that wave pattern that I like in my bangs to kind of set. I've kind of combed it in there and made it start doing what I wanted it to. I'm realizing I need a higher mirror for doing hair videos versus makeup videos, which you would think I would know because my hair is higher on my head than my face. I like my bangs how they're kind of settling in right now, and I think that that means it's kind of time to work on more of the bottom. Now you don't want to run your hands through a fresh set very much because it will start pulling out your curl pretty much immediately. Which is why often I kind of settle for whatever hair the set gives me, especially on the first day. I don't want to manipulate it too much to the point where I have now ruined the curl so much that I get less days out of it. So, I think after I kind of blend and marry this all a little bit more, I might call it, because I want to get at least 3 days out of it. I would love to get more. Some days I can get 5. I've had times where I've even gotten a week out of a set. And it all just depends on how you maintain it with hairspray and brushing, not touching it with your hands too much, and how you sleep in it. I'll make a whole video on how I sleep with my hair and my wet sets, because I think that's the most important part of having and maintaining a vintage hairstyle. So this is nothing too special or out of the ordinary. It's just kind of how I do my everyday set. So it's not a perfect set. It's not anything educational. I pretty much just showed you me brushing and combing out my hair. And frankly, tell me what you want to see in the comments. Tell me what you want for hair and makeup tips. Especially when it comes to hair, I can see what I can do. I'm not a professional hairstylist. I style wigs in my own hair. So this is all coming from like a novice point of view almost. But that, I think, means that it's stuff that pretty much anybody who wants a vintage hairstyle can grasp. Thanks for watching. Subscribe if you want more strange, partially educational videos. Thank you.